Hey everyone, I was tasked to talk about Conda and containers, and especially how the bioinformatic community is auto-generating containers out of packages, with a special emphasis on findability and how do our workflow engines retrieve these containers in an efficient way. If you think about it, containers are just another way to package tools, and there are package managers out there like apt or yum that does that for ages. We have also these language-specific package managers like pip or cran that have a lot of metadata associated and that do know how to package and how to compile their tools. So doing it in a Docker file like people did it a few years ago is not very efficient in a community building perspective, and it's kind of reinventing the wheel yet again. So what we have developed is kind of a tool that is called Malt that automatically converts a package into your container. And by default, we generate your Rocket, Singularity, and Docker images, and yeah, distribute it to our community. Over the last years, we have created 40,000 containers for approximately 8,000 tools. And this is one of the benefits. We don't want to maintain 8,000 Docker files next to our Conda packages and so on. So how do we do that? So how do we do that automatically and efficiently? And for that, we created a nice command line tool. So given you want to have a container for a tool that is called SEMTools in version 1.3.1, if you type in this command line, this malt build, you can specify you want to build and test a tool. You just give it the name and the version of the package that you want to containerize. And then you can also put a test in here. And the tool will create you the given container. So the container name is SEMTools in this specific version, and the container is minimal. It just contains two layers. One is a busy box, and the other layer is the SEMTools binary in this case. We use a technique that is called layer donning, which is simply copying the layer from a build container to a runtime container. You can think about it like the build stages in a Docker file, but again, without a Docker file, and this technique we developed years before the build stages were introduced. And this also works for multiple packages. So if you actually have a need to have a container that has multiple tools inside, you can simply specify your list of tools, if you like, with a given version, and it will create your container. So this entire setup can be completely automatized. So there are no pets anymore, it's just kettles. And if you create 8,000 containers, and if we really think about multi-tool containers, so containers with multiple tools inside, we have a problem of how to name the containers. So you can easily imagine if you want to have a container with 10 tools inside, it's nearly impossible to have a kind of meaningful name of the container that everyone can guess beforehand. So ideally, what we want is that we don't search for containers, but that automatic systems like workflow engines can create the name a priori and then just fetch the container down. So what we are doing is we normalize the package names, means we order them in a specific order, and we hash them. We do the same for the versions, so we normalize the versions and we hash them. And then we have a naming scheme, so this is the hash version more or less that we use, so we can improve over time the hash version. But essentially this is the container name that you get. The obvious disadvantage is that this is not human readable, but these containers are also not created to be human readable. They are completely created automatically, and they are created that automatic systems like workflow engines can create, given this requirement of a specific step in your workflow, can create the container name and just fetch down the container. And this really improves the findability, because actually you don't need to search anymore. You just retrieve or you fail. If the container is not there, you can fail because the container was not created. But this also means that you can build containers on the fly in an automatic way from packages. Or you can build these containers a priori before you run your workflow. So you can, for example, monitor GitHub repositories for workflows and then just build containers given the requirement of the packages that a specific workflow needs. So for example, what we also offer to the community is a GitHub repository where you just need to add a file where you specify your targets and optionally a build image. And given this pull request gets merged, you get such a container automatically created, and you can, and every container engine, every workflow engine can then fetch down this container with the hashed name. Thinking that a step further, we probably don't want to create these pull requests, but we want to take a bot and do it for us. And this is also what we are doing here. So we created a bot that iterates over GitHub, searches for workflows, so for scientific workflows, and creates containers for these workflows. And this example here, again, our BED tools example and SEM tools. So as soon as I publish the workflow, as soon as it's on GitHub, this bot will create this pull request, it gets merged, the container will be available, and the workflow can now run in containers. Yeah, that's already it. If you have any questions, let me know. I would like to acknowledge the entire community that is using the containers, that are mirroring these containers in different locations of the world, and that has helped developing it, and especially also the Bioconda community, which packages we use to build these containers for us. Thanks a lot and enjoy the conference. Bye bye.